government's hands, voters, quotas, rules and rules. Such a ban from the public schools, shouted us to down our tools. Don't give a damn for washed up fools. Hold your heads up to the sky. Stand together to survive with strong hearts and minds.
The reason I came up with the album title Hearts and Minds is because I felt that the title really was incorporating everything that the songs and the style of the music were representing. I mean, that was the reason behind the title. Plus, it was the first song that I wrote for that record, so it felt pretty poignant to give the whole record that name. And it's track one of the new record. It's really a song about sticking together and standing up for what you believe in. It's a community spirit song. It's really quite a powerful anthem when we play it live. It feels like it really uniting the band as well. Track two is called The Watchman. This is a song that I wrote lyrically about Big Brother and about always being watched in society and then trying to escape. And musically, as I remember, it's the first one we recorded in the session Hearts and Minds, when we recorded it in Wales, and we literally played it down once, and that's what you're hearing on the record. It's incredibly tight what Simon and Ben are doing within that track. Incredible playing, and Benji on the banjo is always superb. So it's a really good groove, that one. It's a song I, probably my favourite really on the record. Tiny world, tiny world. Then we've got a sort of poppy, folky song that I wrote called Tiny World. This is a song I wrote on the fiddle. Lyrically, it's kind of a snapshot of two people and their last night together, united in their own little world, and that's how I wrote the story of Tiny World. But musically, it was great. We added a fantastic box player, a guy called Chris Hall, who's a great Cajun player. And it's just got a lot of hooks to the song, and it feels like it's perfect for the release of the record within this summer. So hopefully, people can turn it up loud and jump around to it. It's really quite a dancey, sing-along kind of chorusy song, which we don't usually produce, to be honest. But yeah, we really like that one. Spinning Days Gone By. And then we move on to a ballad called Spinning Days, which is a bit more powerful. It's about the heartache of soldiers dying, about the loss, about the feelings you would get from that. And musically, it's very poignant. Some wonderful banjo playing from Benji and singing from him. I have to say, it's really, it's between me and him, really, that song. It's the way we were exploring the sounds we were creating together to come to the end result of Spinning Days. So it's a really lovely track, that one. If you see them down, see them fly, sky. And then we go into something completely different again, with sort of riff-based. It starts off with fiddle and drums called See Them Dance. It's quite a powerful song. Very similar to Tiny World, lyrically, and the story of two people in their last night together and how the imagery of them dancing in their last night. And musically, pretty riff-tastic, really. We're digging in, me and Ben, certainly, and it really shows off Simon and some fantastic kit playing by him. It's a great band song, that one. Stepping over you. So then we go into a softer song called Stepping Over You, which is a song I wrote about moving forward and believing in yourself. It's musically another playoff between the tenor guitar and Benji's four-string banjo, and the two voices, also some lovely piano playing and some other elements that we brought into it just to really paint as much colour within that song as possible, because it's... I feel like it really takes you on a journey musically, Stepping Over You. It's just a change. Yeah. Then we go into something completely different again. This is called Changes, which is a pizzicato fiddle-led song. And myself and Ben came up with the hypnotic riff that repeats itself. And yeah, I guess it's lyrically about remaining steadfast in a ever-revolving world. I mean, that was the idea behind the lyrics of that song. And musically, it's got the beautiful guest voice of a fantastic singer called Olivia Cheney, who's an amazing singer-songwriter and folk singer on the scene. And she lends her voice to that song. Very special, yeah, we really like that one. Then we go into a song called Tender Traveller, which is more of a sort of Led Zepp style of tenor guitar, acoustic guitar, playing the riffs, and it's quite a heavy sounding song, pretty dark, but it's about a journey over Dartmoor and being chased, almost like a hunt. So that's the idea behind Tender Traveller. It's pretty exciting. I mean, it's pretty powerful though. It's in your face. And then we go into something called Hard Working Man, which I wrote, which is really based around friends of mine who lost their jobs in the past year and a half, and how they've been struggling, you know, and really it's lyrically about that. And musically, I guess it's very much, again, about the band and about the way we play off each other and experimenting with loads of different instruments. I know the viola, when I dig into that now, it's definitely given it quite a different sound. So the producer Chad Blake, what he did on that record is really brought out some different elements of our playing, and Hard Working Man is a good example of that. So the next song is called Preacher's Ghost. And this is the story of a character who lived in the 19th century called Billy Bray, and he lived down in Bodmin. He was a tin miner and lived a drunken, debauched life until he had a religious awakening one day and became one of the most influential Methodist preachers around Cornwall. Very interesting story, a guy that I felt suited the record because of how much he was struggling through life. And it's quite a spooky tale to remember him, of a guy coming back to life, and that's quite a powerful song. It's quite a bluesy sound that we got from it, and that's again following Benji's banjo, you know, it's really a big part of it, and his vocals. Yeah, it's a cool song. That is it's one we really like to play live. Secrets and lies. And then we finish off with a song called Circle Grows, which is a tenor guitar-led song with Ben playing a fantastic line on the bass. And yeah, it's really about corruption, about being caught in the middle of something, being caught in the shadow of the crows. Black suits all in a row, that's the kind of imagery I had within it, being trapped. And musically, yeah, it's really just one take, being caught in a room. We're trying to present that live sound of myself, Ben and Benji, very late night session that we did right at the end of the recording stint of Hearts and Minds. And that really sums up the whole of the record. That's Hearts and Minds, and we're really proud of it. I think it was a joy to make. It was fantastic working with such an amazing producer like Chad Blake. So We feel like we moved on and we learnt so much, and it's a progressive record, so yeah, very happy with it. Closer to danger and away from the crowds, so silent and still.